If you are new to the channel, make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell, so you don't miss out on anything, because new videos are coming at least 5 times per week. Also, press the like button, share and comment below. Morning. You wake up, pick up a few bites and hurry to work. On the way, you stop by Starbucks, get a coffee to be energized throughout the day, and you might drink another one in the afternoon. Well, that means that you are like one in that 64% of Americans who are enjoying at least one cup of coffee every day. If you are a big fan of coffee, then the cost of it can soon start to add up. That might make you feel a bit of guilt and wonder whether you should be saving that money instead. Some statistics. Americans drink almost 150 billion cups of coffee per year. In 2017, Acorns investing app did a survey in which respondents said they spend about $1,100 a year on coffee. For 34% of them, that was more than they invested. Even if you did not invest that money, you could still buy maybe a couch or a new TV for the price of those cups. $1,100 a year is about $3 each day. Financial gurus now ask, why spend money on coffee when you can make it at home for much cheaper? In a way, financially speaking, they are right. For example, the average retail price for roasted coffee is about $6. You can make 20 cups of coffee, that is, you end up paying only 30 cents, 10 times less than buying the $3 coffee, or maybe the $5 coffee for that matter. Let's suppose a 25-year-old starts saving $5 a day, or $35 a week at an annual average interest rate of just 5%. By age 65, this individual will have accumulated almost $230,000, due to disciplined saving and compound growth. With that money, you could buy a decent home in pretty much any state in the US. Behind this spending on coffee lies the so-called latte factor idea. It is basically the idea of giving up your daily cup of coffee, or similar indulgence, to invest the money you would have spent, and over time, this small sacrifice becomes a small fortune. But does this really work in real life? The answer is yes, but you'd need to start early on to see a sizable difference. The main idea, after all, is to start saving as much as you can. You don't have to make huge sacrifices though, because life is meant to be lived. But reality is, that investing is the key to growing wealth. So if coffee, or any other indulgence is ruining your long-term savings efforts, it's time to reconsider priorities and start working toward clear goals. Thanks again for watching.